Hello again. In this lesson, we will continue with what we had done in lesson 10. So in lesson 10, we had seen how to create a smart filter using data that comes from an OpenERP application. Now in lesson 11, we want to continue with the same model that we had used in lesson 10, but now we don't want to create a smart filter. What we want to do is that we want to create a query by example document, and this query by example document again, it focuses on data inquiry. In that what we are going to do is that we are going to take a few tables from our OpenERP application, and then we will create a model out of that table or several tables, and then we will present that model to the end user so that they can do their own queries. So we will allow them to query the database and then abstract the tables so that they will not write SQL queries, but rather what they will do is that they will use drag and drop and click so that they can query any data in the database. This is useful for users maybe who are in finance, who don't want you to create for them reports. What they want to do is that they want to analyze the data themselves, and then they want to be able to export that data into Excel or to other applications for further analysis. So the major point about QBE is that it is focused on data inquiry. It is not focused on the presentation of the data the way we do with BART or the other applications. Our major focus with QBE will be data inquiry. So there are several things that we use for query by example. The first thing is that it allows us to define queries in a visual way, as I've said. So somebody or the end user will just be drag and dropping on the QBE document so that they can be able to query the OpenERP database. Then they'll be able to execute those queries. And the most important thing is that when they execute a query and they are satisfied with the data that they have seen, they will be able to save that query so that they can base other documents on the queries that they have saved. Or they can also share that query with other users in their department. Okay, and then another important thing is that the data that they get, they can export it into other applications. As I have said, they can export it to PDF, they can export it to Microsoft Word, rich text format, they can also export it to Excel for further analysis. So if you have a user who is an expert in Excel, you can give him a query by example document, let him export his own data into a format that he wants, and continue analysis outside of Spago BI. All right, so as we have said, we will not be creating again the connection to the OpenERP database, the one we are hosting on the cloud for these trainings, because we have done that in lesson 10. So the prerequisite for lesson 11 is that go back to lesson 10 if you have not done so, and then cover that lesson before we come to lesson 11. All right, so let's go to our studio. Okay, in the studio we had already created in our smart filter, we had already created various projects. So we are going to use the same projects that we had been using. Okay, so let's go to OpenERP smart filter. So right click on your business model, then go to edit and then add relationship. Okay, so here you can put any name for the relationship, and then we will create a relationship between sales and account. So remember, in sales we have a foreign key account ID which connects to your primary key in account table called ID, and then I'll just change the cardinality there. And once I've done that, I'll add relationship and click on finish. Okay, next we need to create a relationship between sales and company. So again, right click on your business model, go to edit, add relationship. So source is sales, and then we are going to company. So you check for the foreign key in your sales table. Company ID, the primary key in the company is ID. Again, I'll change cardinality, and then I'll add my relationship. Then I'll finish. So I'm done with the relationship. Save your document. Once you've saved your document, now upload it to your Spago BI server. Alright, so now let's upload our data mat to the server. So right click here, then you say upload data mat and model on server. Alright, then select the data source that we had created previously in lesson 10. So we are using ERP, and then click on deploy. So it will tell you successfully uploaded to resources. Okay, so now when we go to Spago BI, under your document root, BI admin, you are going to find your OpenERP QBE document. So just click on it so that it opens. Okay, so here you can see that we have the various tables that we had pulled from our OpenERP server. So under sales, we have several attributes or columns that are of type attribute. And also in lesson 10, you had seen that we had put some columns to be of type measures. So like this is a measure, a measure. And there is a relationship here, if you can see, okay, between this and company, between this sales and company. Alright, so the first thing that we want to do is that we want to see, just like we did with the smart filter, how to create a query. So assuming that you had given this model to somebody in finance and they wanted to see what are the total invoices that have not been paid, they will do something like this. They'll click here and then they'll drag the invoice date here. Maybe they will alias it if they want, but I think the name is okay. Then they will also be interested in the amount total here. And we had seen previously that this amount is total sales in the sales currency. So you can say amount in sales currency. Since this company sells services all over the world, sometimes they sell in dollars, sometimes they sell in euros. So you have to define the sales currency. So price per unit also we can put, and then we can put the name of the product that you are selling, and then maybe the company name, then also the sales currency code, and then click on preview. So now you can see that this is the date of the invoice. So this is the amount in sales currency. And what is that sales currency? Here it is. So this is the amount in euros. This is amount in USD. And this is the name of the product that was sold. Okay. And several other fields that the user might be interested in. So where does all this information come from? As we had seen previously, this information comes from an OpenERP server. So if you go back to learnspagobi.com, and you click on OpenERP/Odoo server, just open it in a new tab. Of course, in the file that you had downloaded under your server resources, you are going to find the password to this server. So if you go to sales in your OpenERP, if you go to sales, and then here now you can create sales orders, you can create quotations. Okay, then you can also create various invoices. So what we'll be doing is that once we have created a document, we'll come here and create and sell a product, and then we see whether it reflects in Spago BI. Okay, so that is the OpenERP Odoo server. So what we'll encourage you to do is to create the document, come here, create or sell some products, check with your Spago BI and see that you are doing it correctly. Another thing that you will need is the database. So again, when you open the database, the password is in the file you downloaded. Sorry. So as we had seen again previously in the previous lesson, the view that we are going to be using is this one. So when you make a sale, you just come here and confirm that it has been reflected. So when you click on browse on your database, you should be able to see the data here. So this is the data that we are trying to report on from Spago BI. But now you see that the user does not need to come and run queries in your database server. Because you have created a model from these tables, all he needs to know is that there's a model called OpenERP Sales, and then from that model he can create his various documents. So when you preview, you will get this data. Now what you need to do is that you need to go to worksheet so that you can create the various documents that comes with your QBE. So the first document that we want to create is a bar chart. Okay, so we'll drag and drop it here. Now remember, down here you can create several worksheets. So this is sheet 1. In sheet 1 we have a bar chart. You can rename that sheet, just call it a bar chart. Alright, so we're going to select the first we'll select a stacked bar chart. We'll select stacked bar chart because we want to have two series. So once you've selected the type of bar chart you want, then here under selected fields, for the series we want to look at the price per unit and amount in sales currency. Those will be our series. Then we want to group by the product, we want to group by the name of the product. So that will be our group, the name of the product. So click on name and put it on category. Once you do that, okay, there are some other things that you can change. Like if you want to change the orientation of your chart, if you don't want vertical, you can make it horizontal. Then you can also show the values on the chart if you want, and you can also show the legend if you want. For now, we'll just leave the defaults. Click on preview. Okay, and you see that will be our chart. We have so much data, that is why it's so. Here you have the amount in sales currency, and then on top there you have the price per unit. So again, amount in sales currency, then on top there we have the product per unit. So we'll go back to the designer. Now instead of grouping by the name, let's group by the sales currency. Let's preview that again. Alright, so you can see that we have made more sales in euro than in USD. More sales in euro than in USD. And also you can see the price per unit is lower in euro as compared, higher in euro than compared to USD. So this one way you can do your charts. Now here you can see that this is just the first worksheet. You can have as many sheets as you like down here. Now one other thing that we can do is that you can put a filter so that somebody can just filter out the data that he doesn't need. For example, what if I wanted to check the data for only a particular day? For example, I can put the date of the invoice as the filter. Then when I click on preview, I can say that I only want to see data for maybe 1st, 15th and 25th. Okay, then I click on filter. So that will only show me data for the dates that I have selected, and both for euro and USD. If you want also, you can add another filter so that you can also filter out the currency code. So maybe you only want to check data for USD. Okay, so if I only wanted to check data for USD, I will click here and then I click on filter. Alright, so let's click here and add another sheet. Now in this other sheet, we want to change the layout. So we'll use this layout. Now it will allow us to have a title for our worksheet. So here we can say the sales pie chart. So we want to create a pie chart. Then again we go to palette, we drag a pie chart here. Once you have dragged a pie chart there, then you go to selected fields. Now what we want to do is that we want to see the price per unit. Want to see is not price per unit but amount as our series. And then we want to look at the sales currency as our category. So we want to see in a pie chart which one gives us more money, sales in USD or sales in Euro. So by default, the first worksheet is the one that will be opened. So if I click on sheet 2, it will open for me the pie chart. So from the pie chart, you can see that it's difficult to tell unless you highlight, because we did not put the legend. So if I go back to designer and then I say show values, show legend, and then show percentage value, then again I preview. So I go to sheet 2. Okay, now it's easy to see that the euro is makes 98.38% of our sales in euro as compared to USD. All right, so going back to the palette, we see that we can also create a line chart. So we'll create a different worksheet for that. Then as is customary now, we go to selected fields. We select for the series amount in sales currency. And then for the category, we can do a date. And then we can preview. So we go to sheet 3. That's where our line chart is. Okay, so you can see that by date, the sales were highest on 9th, on 23rd. So you can map this month on month so that you can see how you are, how your sales are, your sales people are doing. Okay, so in the palette there are other things. Maybe we can do a table and then we stop there, because the procedure is the same. So for your table, you just select the fields that you want to display. So maybe we want to display the name of the company, and then we want to display the product you are selling, and then we want to display the amount, and then maybe the currency code. Again, you remember, you can put as many filters as you want. So we go to sheet 4, and you have your data there. Now one more thing that you can do is that there are several things you can do here. You can export this data, okay, to PDF, to Excel, to CSV, RTF, and the modern version of Excel. So all these are available. So assuming that the person that wanted this data is an accountant, he will most probably export to Excel and then continue analyzing the data from Excel. Also, you can export to PDF if you wanted to send it to somebody and you do not want it to be changed. Something else that you can copy this data to your personal folder, but since it already exists, remember the model is there in our personal folder. Something interesting is here, show customized view and add to customized view. So when you click on add to customized views, what happens is that this instance of the query that we have just run, we will save it the way it is, so that when we open it, it's like bookmarking. You can have several queries saved so that you can always come back and click on the one that that you need. Okay, so those are the options that you can use. So once you save, you can view it with the show customized view. Okay, you can reload the data, refresh your document execution, and you can save. Okay, so you have all those options. So QBE is really not difficult. As you have seen, it's very similar to what we had done with Smart View. And once you understand Smart View, doing QBE becomes much, much easier. So let's do one thing now. What we'll do is that we'll go to our OpenERP and we do a sale in Kenya shilling. We have seen that we have sales in USD and we also have sales in Euro. So why don't we just create a quotation in our Udo server and then we see if it's reflected in Spago BI. Okay, so I'll create a quotation. So I'll select Charlie as my customer. The date is the same. So my price list will be in Kenya shilling. So I'll add an item. So the item that I want to sell is Linux server. Okay, so it will be worth 5,000 shillings. Then I'll save my quotation. So once I've saved my quotation, I'll confirm the sale. So once I've confirmed my sale, I generate an invoice. So I'll create an invoice. So I'll just invoice the whole of the sales order. So I'll create an invoice and view it. Then next, validate the invoice because it's in draft. Okay, so going to your PHP admin, just refresh to see before we register that payment that the row is there. So you can see that we have that row, Linux server, and the sales is in Kenya shilling, the product sales currency code, okay, and the sale was for 5,000 shilling. So we have seen that once we have created the invoice, it also registers on the database, but on the database you can see that it is opened, it has not been paid. So open. So what we'll do is that we will go to our Spago BI and we will refresh this data. Okay, once we have refreshed the data, let's see if that information is there. Remember, we did not save, that is why the data disappeared. So we go to preview and let's see if the last sale that we have just made is there. So how can we tell that? What we can do is that we can add a filter. We can add a filter in our worksheet. So we'll go to worksheet, we'll create a table, and then we'll select fields. So we need the invoice date, we'll need amount total in company currency, we'll need the amount total in sales currency, and then we'll also need company currency code and the product currency code, and then we also need the state of the invoice. Alright, so once you've done that, we will add a filter, and the filter will be the product sales currency code. Let's preview and see if the invoice we just created have been reflected in our QBE document. Okay, so there we are. But we are only interested in products that have been sold in Kenya shilling, because that's what we've just done now. So we'll filter by Kenya shilling. Okay, so we can see that the invoice we just raised on this date, the amount is 5,000, amount total is this, and the company currency code is Kenya shilling, the product sales currency code is also Kenya shilling, and the state is open. So this is the invoice that we have just raised in the OpenERP. So this is the invoice number. And we have also seen that the invoice also reflects in our database. So what we want is that we don't want the users to come to the database. We just create for them a model like this one. Then from here, they can create as many documents as they want. They can create tables, they can create bar charts, pie charts, pivot tables, static pivot tables, and they can export this data. If I remove the filter again and run it, I should be able to export this file into Excel, for example, if I wanted to do that, assuming I was an accountant. Okay, so once I've exported to Excel, I can open it now and play around with the values in my Excel. So that's the power of a query by example. You give the users the opportunity to query the data in the format that they want and export it also in the format that they want. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video, which will be what if. So we are going to continue analyzing the data. We have done so with smart filters. Now we understand query by example. Now the next thing that we want to do is to use a what if engine so that we can see how to ask questions of our data. For example, we will see how to use it to analyze the effect of changing currency on changing currency rates on our sales. Like we have said, if you sell all over the world in euros or in USD, but you know you pay your taxes in your local currency, so if USD or euro goes up or goes down, it will affect your bottom line negatively or positively. So you can use the what if function of Spago BI to help you analyze that kind of trend. So I'll see you in the next video.